Jermaine.
Expression. I don't know.
What's in an expression? Describe it.
The forms of the P, E, M, D, A, and S.
What is it?
Purple elephant may destroy a school.
What do you use that for?
For to help you with multiplying the individual.
To do what? Evaluate your expression.
Yeah.
So what's included in expression? Look at your expression on the board. And what do you see in the expression?
Subtraction, multiply, divide, exponent,
and.
So an expression includes numbers and operations. And you've done order of operations so that you know how to evaluate the expression, right? No?
Yeah.
So what do you do first when you evaluate the expression?
You.
Parentheses,
exponent, multiply, divide,
subtract,
add, and.
Okay. Now, so you know how to evaluate expression. We're going to build on that, and there are different types of expression. There are two types. The first one that you've been doing is called numerical expression. It's just numbers and operations. Numbers and operations. That's a numerical expression. All right? The second kind is called an algebraic expression. Say it, algebraic.
Algebraic.
That includes numbers, symbols, and operations.
Ooh.
And you said letters. You could say symbols, letters, or variables. It, what it implies is that there it means something, but you don't know exactly what it is. You don't know the value, what it stands for. And the value could change. So you call it a variable. That makes sense?
Yes, ma'am.
A variable is usually a letter. Any letter. A, B, C, Y, Z, K, a letter. You'll see a problem, and an algebraic expression, I'm gonna skip to it on here, includes a variable, and includes a letter. So you'll see a letter, a number, and an operation. Look on the board. A letter, a number, and an operation. You see it?
Yes.
What you're going to learn how to do is to go from words to write an expression. So let's look at it. It says five more than. More than says what?
Add.
So the first operation is to add, right?
Yes.
Okay. Then twice a number. What is twice imply?
That's multiply.
Multiply. So the second operation is multiply. So you're going to add something and you're going to multiply something. You have two operations. Do we agree on that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So the question now is what are we adding and what are we multiplying?
Wait, stop.
So we agree of our operations. We don't know our variable, right? So we said we were going to assign F as the variable.
Yes.
And it's going to mean that's going to be a number. We don't know what it is. We don't know what it represents. It's just a number.
Just a letter. Yeah.
Just a letter. That represents something, but we don't know what. Do we agree on that? Go get your eraser from the back. Do we agree on that? Everybody agree?
Yes,
we have operation, addition, and multiplication.
Yes, ma'am.
And we agree that our variable is F.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
It represents a number.
You can erase the 5 plus 2.
No, I don't want to erase that. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, sir. Do we agree on that?
Yes.
Okay. Second part. Do we see any numbers? So let's agree on the numbers that we'll include. Do we see any numbers in our sentence?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we do. What's this?
Oh, yeah.
Five. And what number goes with? There's another number. What?
Two.
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 So we agree that we have addition, multiplication, the number five, and the number two. Do we agree on that?
Yes.
And we agree that our variable is an F.
Yes.
We agree on those three things. So we've already decided our sentence, our math sentence, put your foot down. Do not do that. Your feet belong on the floor. You understand?
I think I understand.
So we have symbols, which are variables. We have numbers, and we have operations to make an algebraic expression. Do we all agree on that? All right. We've already agreed that our algebraic expression will include the operations of addition and multiplication. Is that correct? We agree the numbers are 5 and 2.
Twice is 2.
Twice is 2. And we agree on our variable is F. So our variable is F, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So we need to now write an algebraic expression that includes all 5 of these items. Everybody understand? Right?
Okay. Yeah.
So let's go back to our sentence. 5 more than... Let's just stop there. 5 more than. What does that tell us to do?
Multiply.
Subtract.
Subtract.
You said more than?
More than.
Add.
If you agree with add, raise your hand.
You said more than, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Add.
Okay. If you agree with multiply, raise your hand.
No.
If you agree with divide, raise your hand.
You said more.
If you agree with subtract, raise your hand. What are you saying? You said subtract?
Okay. I said divide.
Okay. So 5 more than. All right.
Yeah.
Cavante, get on the number line. Start at 0. Wait a minute. All right. You're at 0, right? Go to 5 more than Cavante. No,
Cobb.
1, 2, 3.
You
see
5, yeah?
Go on 5.
Huh?
Okay. So to get from 0 to 5, what do you do?
Subtract.
What do you do?
Subtract.
To go from 0?
Hey.
Okay. So 5 more than is what? What I'm reading. Whenever you have a number and a variable side by side, it implies multiplication. Whenever you have a number and a variable side by side, instead of writing the multiplication sign, it implies multiplication. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So, we used everything that we agreed upon to write our sentence.